Hello YouTube, you're Toomy here, and this is the beginning of a change. You know, I've done a lot of gaming and everything, and in the recent years, I've done a lot of gaming. And it's been a process of catching up to those who have had consoles their entire life. Only the year before I went to college did I get a console. So, it's been a process. And now I've caught up. I caught up to where I want to be. Caught up to those who have gotten consoles and everything like that. And so I'm going to be slowing down. Not much more gaming left for me. Hour to hour tops a day. And when you're playing RPGs, which RPGs average around 55 hours, and normal games average around 9 hours, then it's going to be a while that I'm going to finish each game. Some I might not even finish. So, this is it. I'm going to be telling you what my plans are for the future on gaming, and it's, let me just show you. Alright, so, I have a few arcade games. If I had the money, I would waste my time on spending, and these are the games that are already out, but I'm not really enthusiastic about buying, so I'm not buying unless I have the money, which I don't. Alright, the first one is an arcade game, Darkest of Days. When I was a kid, I actually made a fiction that was almost exactly the story of that game, which is really nice. I also got Pioneer, which reminds me of Oregon Trail, Keflings, Anomaly, Fairy Legends of Avalon. Yeah, it sounds and looks really, you know. But who cares? I was interested. I'm securing my masculinity. Hydrophobia. That was interesting. That's all I have to say about that. Alright, game, the $60 games that, I don't know, if they're in the bargain bin, I'll get. Assassin's Creed Revelations, Riddick, Assault on Dark Athena, Burnout, whichever game in the series, Child of Eden, Divinity 2, The Dragon Knight Saga. That game has bad graphics, but it looks like it'd be a cool universe and cool gameplay. Forza 4, Kingdoms of Amalur: Reckoning, Medal of Honor, Spider-Man Shattered Dimensions, Transformers War for Cybertron, Two Worlds, Witcher 2, X-Men Destiny, and that's it. That is the games left that I haven't played. And it's amazing how many games I have played. My Xbox says that I've played at least 78 games on that console alone. That's not including the PS3 games that I've played and the games that I played on my friend's Xbox. So, I've played probably over at least 120 games. And that is an insane amount. But another thing to add is, in the future, I don't have a long list. I don't have, like, 120 games that I'm looking forward to. I only have 3 next year. If I finish those off in a week, I'm gonna have no games. So, 3 games I'm looking forward to next year. Assassin's Creed 3, Watch Dogs, and Splinter Cell Blacklist. And, oh yeah, I forgot, Dead Space 3. I need to add that on the list.
And those four games. And then that's it. That will be the end of the generation. It's been a good generation, I gotta say, the 360 generation. But what has been your guys' favorite game? And what are you looking forward to next year? And this is me sort of signing off on the gaming thing. Because I have to start working a little bit harder and all that. So, without much ado, although I've already given a bunch of ado already, this is me signing off. Peace.